In this lecture, I'm going to show you how to set up Eclipse for JUnit test. JUnit on Blue Jay and Eclipse. JUnit is an API, so it works for both Blue Jay and Eclipse. There is not much difference between them because the unit testing framework is independent of IDEs. It will work for Blue Jay, Eclipse, and NetBeans. BlueJ is a lightweight IDE, no find and replace, not much plugins, not cross-language platform, simple package and module management. The file management for BlueJ is just like the test file, not much difference. The functionality is limited because it's easy to use. It is just a little bit bigger than Notepad. All of the files it created can be copied into Eclipse environment very easily. But you cannot copy Eclipse file back to BlueJ without much change. Eclipse is the de facto industrial standard for Java IDE and many other languages. So Eclipse is very useful. Code development between the two IDE brings some advantage. Compilation for BlueJ is faster, but not enough for big projects. And right here, I show you how to port the program from BlueJ to Eclipse. That will make you capable of using both of the tools. And let's look at the demo. First, you need to look at the junit.org website. And we try to download the junit.jar file. So you click download. And there is a junit.jar. You click it. There is a version called junit-4.12.jar will be downloaded for the newest version. I have already downloaded one version, so let's look at it. Click Show in Folder. In the download folder, you can locate this junit-4.12.jar file. Let's rename it to junit.jar. Then let's copy to the library directory you want to install. Then paste on the destination directory you want to copy the file. So just paste it. And the path is right here. So I have the junit.jar file right here. You can check the property. It is a .jar file for executable jar file. Now, let me show you how to set up the Eclipse environment for junit testing. First, in order to pull the program from BlueJ to Eclipse, you need to new a Java project. Because the package and the project directory are different, so you need to create an Eclipse project. Right here, let's try junit test project. And I don't want to use the default location, so browse in my computer. Right here at my Java directory, I want to make a new folder, junit test project directory, and let me click OK. So right here, I use that directory and click Next. And right here for the library, you need to add that external jar file in. So click external jar. And then select this Udemy-like junit file. And then it's in. You can click it and check that there is certain things there. So I click Finish. And then the project folder is already being created. Now, the next thing I would like to do is to pull the BlueJ files over. In my BlueJ directory, I have the student and student test files. Let me copy them over. Just copy. And then you go to the Java directory. And Java unit test. And source directory. You do test. But the class file and C text file, we don't need it. Just delete it. And after you copy it in, you need to refresh your workspace in order to see it. So that's refresh. And then you click it in the source, and there's a default package. The two files are in. Now let's open this studenttest.java right here, and then let me try to run it. Run as a JUnit test. Okay, there is a certain error, initialization error. The reason why this initialization error happened is because I already has a JUnit package in there, and I copy and set up another copy, and there is a collision. So what I will handle it is, let me go back to the package explorer. I would have look at this refresh library right here. Let me close it. I need to remove it. So I click here, click this one and configure build path. So right here, I select this one and then I say remove. Then that JUnit library is gone. Let me choose the version I have. Right click here and use build path and then add library. And it will pop up because I already installed a version in there. Let me choose this JUnit. And it says JUnit 4. It's okay. Click it. It's under Programs Eclipse plugin. I already installed that plugin through Marketplace. So right now, it's in. Let me run it again. Run as JUnit test. This time, it's a one more error. It happens on test group name. Why? I double-click it. It showed you where the error happened. Because this test group name method need to refer to a names-long.txt. It's not there. So what should we do? We go to the project directory. We come to this Udemy JUnit BlueJ underline BlueJ directory. We need this names long file. Let me copy it back to my JUnit test directory. So right here, click source and paste that text file. Again, let's click the package explorer. And then you do refresh again. And it is in. But it is not a Java file. It's okay. Let me click this. And then run again, run as JUnit test. This time it's still wrong. So why is so? Because this directory is not the project directory. So what we need to do is --src, and because --, you cannot allow it, you need to have a escape sequence, so put --2 in each of them. Now it's okay. That's wrong again. See, this time 444, it passed already. So right here, I show you several topics importing from BlueJ to Eclipse. One thing, you need to check file path name, because the two file systems are totally different. Second, sometimes you copy your file over, but you forget to copy the data file. That's also very important to make sure that your program still can work. Third, by JUnit testing, when some of your system component in your project is missing, it will show up because you rerun the JUnit test that will help you to have a systematic way to make sure your program has the integrity and help you to develop your program by porting here, there, between different platforms and between different tools and make sure it will still work. So download the files and have some fun. Thank you. Bye-bye.